Hey guys, it's Mike with CEPTV, and today we're gonna talk about working on and cleaning out a, what we call a four barrel cartridge filter. We've done single cartridge filter clean out videos before, but we have customers that some of the larger pools are running on what we sell, the JND CV340. And Hayward's also got a model that's a four barrel like this. It's fairly common for the larger pools. So having said that, there's a couple little tricks involved in cleaning these filters. Wanna go over that with you today. The first thing that you wanna do is shut your power off, whether you're an AquaLink app or whatever it is, however you've got yours set up, shut your power to the pump and the system off. The next thing you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna come over here and bleed the air out. In this situation on this Jandy, it's right on the back of this gauge. And while it's bleeding the air out, let's just talk about this gauge for a second. This clean and dirty is not an exact scientific gauge, okay? Depending on how far away you are from your particular pool or whatever, you're gonna find that this clean and dirty is a fairly decent gauge, but is not the only thing that you should be looking at when it comes to cleaning out your pool. If you've seen our videos on how to tell if you've got a clogged filter, that kind of tells you that in some situations, the gauge isn't always accurate, but things like the UV shutting off or water features not performing correctly, things of that nature can also help you figure out whether or not you actually have a flow problem. And the flow problem 9 times out of 10 is going to be clogged filters. Having said that, let's go ahead and take this apart. And this isn't nearly as complicated as it looks, but if you do it this way, you won't have any problems. Trying to do it any other way, you'll have a heck of a problem getting this to seal right. On these larger four barrel filters, you're gonna have one main nut that tightens this band. In this case, on our Jandy CV340, this is a 9/16. You're just gonna go ahead and loosen this up, and you're gonna loosen it all the way up. We wanna move this band right out of here. Take your socket wrench and just kind of put it to the side, break this band open, and just unscrew this right off. Once that's off, we're gonna break our band completely off of here, set it to the side somewhere, and then in this case, we're still kind of draining down a little bit. You can let it drain the whole way, or you can get a little wet and rock this right off of here, in which case, it's just like it sounds. You're gonna rock it right off of there. It's not as hard, by the way, if you let it stop hissing and everything gets drained out, it's a lot easier. Try not to get this in the dirt. Set it somewhere to the side. Even these little tiny stones and stuff like that can keep it from getting a good seal when we go to put it back together. These four barrel filters are notorious for being hard to get to seal, but once we have our top off, then you can see why we call it a four barrel filter. We're gonna take this plastic piece right off of here. That'll just come right off. You can set it to the side. This breathing element here, we're gonna clean that out in a second too as well. But we're gonna set this to the side for now. And then we're just gonna pull our filters out. We're gonna take them all over to our nearest hose. And each one of these filters is about 85.5 square feet, bringing you to a total of 340. One thing that's important to understand when it comes to keeping your pool maintained is it's not enough to simply suck everything out of the pool itself and have it netted. Pool chemistry is important, and also maintenance on the equipment is important, because not doing maintenance makes equipment run poorly, doesn't perform properly, it has less longevity, it doesn't last as long. So in this case here, the gentleman that they have maintaining their pool said that he had everything cleaned out today, and we've just taken the filters apart and realized that it's not. There's a tremendous amount of dirt, and that will just cause you more wear and tear on your equipment than necessary. So it's really important, if you're not doing the maintenance yourself, to make sure that the company that you're paying good money to is indeed maintaining the pool. Having said that, look at how easy this is. It's kind of a shame that it wasn't done. And look at all of the algae and dirt that's just washing right off of this. Just like the single cartridge filter, this is gonna be the same kind of setup. It's this easy, and it's meant to be this easy with a hose. Just simply take and spray this out. It's never gonna get perfectly white again. That's just not gonna happen. These are meant to be sacrificial. They have a lifespan, depending on what you're dealing with and what area you're into, depending on how much you keep, especially oils out of the pool, which we've covered in our single cartridge video. Oils are the biggest problem for these because these will put up with a lot of dirt for a long time, but oil will form a film on the pleats of this cartridge filter and cause it so that even though it looks clean, it's got a film on it that doesn't allow water to pass through it. So this is why hotels and, you know, different fitness clubs, they want you to shower before you get in there. It's not to get the dirt off of you. They're not really concerned about that. They want the oil off of you because oil is what kills these filters. But having said that, if you could get everybody to shower or at least not put on a gallon and a half of suntan oil, or, you know, if you have a, you know, people over that are using tons and tons of conditioner in their hair, it's great to enjoy the pool and then go put all that conditioner back in your hair when you're done. It'll save the life of these filters tremendously. But other than that, we're just gonna go through and we're gonna spray out all four of these filters. Okay, so now that we've washed all the neglect out of these filters, let me just say one thing too. If you're maintaining your own pool, again, like I said, it's real helpful to keep these, but if you're paying somebody to maintain your pool and they're not cleaning out your filters, number one, make sure you're not paying for them to do that. And number two, make sure that they're at least taking care of this, you know, every 3 to 4 weeks at the very longest outset. If you have a lot of leaves, if you have a lot of dirt, dust blown in your area, if you're in an unfinished subdivision, there's really no excuse to not have these things being washed once a week. It's kind of like you don't have to brush your teeth every day, but it's really good for your teeth if you do, and everybody else is happy about it. So anyway, we've got these all cleaned off now. So we're gonna bring these back over and we're gonna move on to the second part of this. Now, what you'll see here, if you look inside the filter, you're gonna see this guy right here. This is your bottom stand. This stand is what the filters sit on the bottom. And this guy is not a big deal to just pull out, set to the side. And then because this was neglected so poorly by not the customer, but the person that they were paying to actually do this job, we need to check and make sure that there's not a whole lot of sediment in the actual filter itself. Now, no matter what kind of filter you have, you can see there's so much that's ended up around here already that I just am not really sure that it's not all throughout the bottom. No matter what kind of filter it is on these four barrels, even on the singles, you're always gonna have a drain plug, okay? On this one, it's right here in the front. And we're just gonna let that drain down so that we can make sure that everything is cleaned out of this filter. And as that's draining down, I'm gonna bring the hose on over here. And we're just gonna proceed to go ahead and rinse everything out. First thing that's most important is this band. You see how this band is pulling in right here? That'll be a problem getting this to reseal. Pull the band right out, rinse the band off. Remember, the smallest grain of sand, this is a high vacuum system. This pump here, this Jandy pump, is moving almost 120 gallons a minute on high. So that's a lot of pressure that's going through this. And the smallest grain of sand is going to cause an issue with getting this to seal. Again, good filter maintenance, just like your teeth. You don't have to get them yanked and get crowns on them if you take care of them. Good filter maintenance is the same thing. You won't have to go to this extreme if it's maintained on a regular basis, but if things get busy and you end up not being able to, or if you're paying somebody and you find out they're not, one way or another, this is the way to make sure that you can completely rejuvenate this thing and get it where it needs to go. And it doesn't matter if it's perfect, you don't have to get in there with a paper towel and get every grain of sand out of the bottom of this. We're talking about more places that seal. So once we've done that, you can see the round parts here, those are gonna go into our filters. So the flat part here is what we want to go down into the base, okay? And then, remember I told you we were gonna rinse off this little breather guy here. We're gonna take care of him. And we're gonna give it a good rinse off here. The first thing that we want to do is to make sure that we clean off our cap really well and seal that back on. This is our drainage cap to drain that filter out. These do like to leak. And even though everything else on this entire system is hand tight, like these quick disconnects everywhere that we see, this one here, you may need to put a little bit of effort on, and it may even require that you put a wrench on it, but you just don't want to wrench too hard on it. But if they're clean, usually you can seal them hand tight, give her a good turn, she's done. Next thing we want to do, so we've got our base in there, so we want to stack our cartridges. Here's one. There is no specific spot. All four of them go in there, not in any sort of order. Just want them all standing up on your nice clean base. And you'll have to slide this around to make them fit right. Okay, now we're gonna take our top piece here, and you're just gonna make sure this tube goes into the pipe. It's gonna sit on there and just give her a little bit of a wiggle until everything feels nice and snug. Once that happens, we're good to go. Well, a couple little things got stuck on our screen here. Once that happens, we're good to go. Now we need our nice clean gasket. Double check that it's clean. This is gonna make or break whether or not you can get her sealed. Take your gasket, run your finger around here one last time, make sure that there's no little pieces of sand that have fallen in, because they will be a problem. If you're not sure, give it another rinse. Telling you, one thing that frustrates people to death is getting these four barrels to seal. It really depends on whether or not this is clean and this gasket's clean. So not only do I rinse it before I put the gasket on, once I get the gasket on, I rinse it again. And the gasket's a bit of a bear. Kind of got to play with it a little bit. Don't get mad at yourself. Even the professionals have to do it this way. So now she's on. We're going to make sure that we give it one more nice little rinse off here all the way around. Then we're going to rinse off the inside rim just to make sure there's nothing on there. We're going to stack it on top. Try to go straight down with it as best you can. You don't want to roll the gasket. Once it's straight down, you can aim this however you want. Once it's straight down, what I recommend is put some pressure on it from the top. Try to get it so that no matter which way you're going, it feels even when you're feeling this edge. If you can get that done just like that, you're in good shape. Now it's time to put our band on. The band, again, we don't want to knock that off of where it's mounted to right now. So take your band and try to just go around it rather than reaming on it. Try to go around it. Before you start tightening the band, feel all the way around the top and the bottom edge to make sure that it's sitting properly. Once you know that it is, squeeze it as hard as you can by hand. Take your nut. And we're gonna take up the slack. And this is gonna pretty much just about touch by the time that we're done. That's how tight it needs to be. All right, you can see how tight this is. Right here, there's almost no gap at all in here. If you follow these reassembly instructions properly, exactly as I'm telling you to do, you will not have a problem. If you don't, this will leak when you fire it up. Right now, we're gonna go ahead and put this on. We're gonna check for leaks. We're leaving our air bleeder open so that it can fill this up, push all the air out, and then when this starts spitting water out, we're gonna close it. All right, now it's time to close it. And you want to inspect for leaks. All around here, I know it's wet because you just did this, but you'll know a leak. It's going to drip right down. We have a nice solid seal on this. We have a nice solid seal on our cap. That's important. So once again, to wrap this up, it's really important that you follow these instructions on how to get these back together. The biggest problems and complaints we have from customers are that they're leaking around the band. They put it on, they can't get it to work. That grain of sand, I'm telling you, will do it. That's the way that you need to do this step by step. And if you do, you're never gonna have a problem with these filters. Now these guys will go for quite a while. In this situation here too, just covering this clean and dirty, what I like to do is when I first have a brand new, either clean or a brand new filter, I just check and make sure it should be set. These are turnable dials, the Haywards, the Pentairs, they're all turnable dials. You're gonna wanna put it to where it's clean. Don't use a manual, put it to where it's clean when you have a completely clean system and clean filters, and you'll be able to kind of have a good idea, good guide on that. Now, it's really also important to make sure, again, like I said, that just because the pool's still working doesn't mean that you ignore what's going on with the filter. Good filter maintenance saves that pump from having to work twice as hard. Make sure the UV keeps going, make sure the heater keeps firing. All of these things are really important, and they all have to do with making sure that this filter system is clean. So guys, I hope that was very informative for you, and we will see you on the next one.